Welcome to FCN. We're in Germany en route to Switzerland for what promises to be a pretty special day. A full 10 years after the launch, we're about to get the first ever test ride on the Foggy Petronas FP1. Well, we've spoken to Livio and we should be pretty close now, so it should be anywhere here now. Hang on, look. Whoa, there it is.
Whoa.
Hey.
Hello.
Livio, how are you going, man? Michael.
Yes, good.
Good to see you. Live, the FP1.
Yes, you like?
It looks beautiful. Amazing.
Yeah, it's a very nice bike.
It's a long time since I've seen one.
You never seen before the street bike?
No, I don't think I have actually.
Okay.
The race bike for sure, but not the street bike.
Then I think we go testing.
Yeah, it's incredibly smooth, the engine. Okay, I haven't revved it so much yet, but the power is beautiful.
Yes, it's very smooth.
And the noise is great. As soon as you get over like 4,000 or 5,000.
The sound is like a Ferrari 12 cylinder.
Yeah, sounds good.
Yeah.
But my initial impression is that it feels more race bike than road bike. You know, the way the slipper clutch works.
It's a race bike for the street.
Yeah. The position.
Yeah, you feel the frame and.
Yeah, stiff, feels stiff.
Yes.
Yeah. Well, what's it like to ride? I'm not going to compare it against a modern 1000cc sports bike because that really wouldn't be fair. The moment you turn the key, it's obviously something, it feels like something special. The FP1 flashes up on the dash. You pull the clutch in, it's a dry clutch, you get that trademark rattle like a Ducati. And on the move, I mean, the initial fueling of the bike, you know, low down, anything under sort of 3,000-4,000, it's quite lumpy, it's quite harsh, and the initial tap of the throttle is quite brutal. But the moment you actually get beyond that and get driving the bike and get flowing the bike, the power delivery is really, really very nice. It's incredibly smooth. It feels completely linear. You don't have any real surge of power when you get to, you know, 7,000-8,000 RPM. It pretty much from 4,000 to 12,000 when the limiter comes in, it is just completely linear. This really has been a great experience. The bike may be 10 years old, but it stood the test of time incredibly well. You know, we met someone in the town who asked if it was a new bike, and then I told him it was a 10-year-old bike, and he was kind of a bit bemused by that. The bottom line is that it still feels, it was something special at the time, and even by today's standards, it is something special. I think if you rode this down the street, you are going to get people looking at you like, can't think of many other bikes where you get that same sort of result. So thanks to Livio, we've had a great day, and maybe, just maybe, we're going to see a few more of these bikes around the world.